Biochemical sedimentary rocks help provide a record of organisms and environments in Earth's history.
This mini video explains how biochemical sedimentary rocks are formed.
Check out this related video for a discussion of the classification of all types of sedimentary rocks.
The shells that protect shellfish, like these oysters,
or clams, or mussels, and even the smallest plankton floating in the ocean, are formed when these organisms extract ions of some common elements from seawater.
These elements precipitate out of seawater to build shells, which later collect on the seafloor and are converted into a biochemical sedimentary rock.
For example, the limestone cliffs of El Capitan in West Texas were originally formed 280 million years ago as a combination of algae, sponges, and bryozoans precipitated limestone out of the shallow seawater to build up a reef. Much like the corals of today.
Even single-celled marine plants like these coccolithophores can cause precipitation. These tiny plankton-like organisms are made up of plates of the mineral calcite.
Even though you couldn't see a coccolithophore with your naked eye, if enough of them are deposited together, they can form spectacular chalk cliffs like these along the southeast coast of England.
Biochemical limestone forms from an array of marine organisms that build their skeletons or shells by precipitation from seawater, and later die to form sedimentary rocks.
Some marine organisms precipitate silica rather than calcite, and their deposits will eventually be converted to the sedimentary rock chert.
Plants on land can also end up as rock. Today's coal was formed from trees and other vegetation growing in ancient forests. To form coal, you need lots of vegetation that can be buried rapidly in warm, wet environments like tropical swamps.
Coal deposits begin as spongy peat that can contain lots of woody fragments and a relatively low carbon content.
With more time and burial, the carbon content increases and the organic material passes through several stages, eventually forming bituminous coal or anthracite.
So we have introduced you to several types of biochemical sedimentary rocks that formed as a result of the actions of organisms or were formed from their dead remains.
So how confident are you that you could meet the learning objective for this lesson?